This is Superman's headquarters, the Fortress of Solitude. It's made from sunstone crystal, and even though this crystal isn't real, the way it grows looks a bit like the way some crystals grow in real life. Just without the explosion at the end. And because Lego Superman needs headquarters for him and his buddies, I'm going to make a miniature Fortress of Solitude from real crystals. Want to see how it's done?
Then let's get science.
To make the miniature fortress, you'll need warm water, measuring cups, a jug, a medium-sized container, and a large pot. You'll also need a substance that forms crystals that looks like those in the movie. Sugar, salt, and even borax all make really nice crystals that look like this, this, and this. But none of these look like the thin, colorless crystals seen in the movie. Luckily, while running a bath to help me think, I found the perfect substance, Epsom salt. Epsom salt, also known as magnesium sulfate heptahydrate, is safe to handle and can be found online and in the soap aisle of most supermarkets. It forms long, colorless crystals that look a lot like the crystals in the Fortress of Solitude. So now we have a substance for our crystals. Ask an adult to help you with the following steps. First, pour 1¼ cups of Epsom salt into a jug and add 1 cup of warm water. Give this a stir for 2 minutes and watch as the Epsom salt starts to dissolve. After 2 minutes, there might still be some undissolved Epsom salt. In this case, microwave the jug on high for 30 seconds and stir for another 2 minutes. If there's still undissolved salt, repeat both of these steps again. Heating the water helps more salt to dissolve. Once all of the Epsom salt has dissolved, pour the solution into a container and place this container in a large pot. Add warm water to the pot until it's at the level of the water in the container and leave this to cool overnight. The next morning, add a teaspoon of Epsom salt to the container. These will act as seed crystals. Then place the pot in the fridge and leave it to cool for at least 8 hours. Later that day, take the pot out of the fridge, remove the container, and look at all the crystals. Whoa! These crystals are the start of our fortress. We could stop here and have some really cool crystals, but I'm gonna try to make them look a bit more like the Fortress of Solitude. Because the crystals grew in a square container, they've taken the shape of a square. I couldn't find an above shot of the fortress, but judging by this shot in the movie and this graphic in the comics, I'm thinking it might be something like this. So the first thing I'm going to do is pour out the excess solution, carefully remove the crystals from the container, and cut out this shape from the block of crystals. This is looking a lot better, but these crystals are still quite small and not really the right size for Superman. So the next thing I'm going to do is make these crystals bigger. To do this, I'm going to make a double batch of Epsom salt solution and carefully place this new solution and the crystal base back into the container. And just like before, I'll add this to a pot with some warm water, leave it to cool overnight on the bench, and place it in the fridge for 24 hours. When we first add the new solution, some of the crystal base dissolves. But when we let this cool in the fridge, we get really good crystals. To stop the crystal base from dissolving, I also tried letting the new solution cool before adding it to the container. But this gave me a lot of little crystals. So I think this is a pretty good method, but please try experimenting with it yourself to see if you can improve it. So after another day in the fridge, let's take a look at the final Fortress of Solitude. Awesome! I was really happy with how this turned out. Superman and his buddies look really happy as well. As always, thanks for watching this episode of Silly Science with Simon.